So here is a map of the activities we're going to be involved in today. So we're starting our hike here on the Argentina side.
If he is the herd guardian.
Oh my goodness.
An alternative to our walk is just taking the train, I guess.
Well, we just passed station here, the toilet area, and now we are at the beginning of the upper trail. Easy to.
So we have arrived at the upper trail. We start out by walking on a bridge over looking at this little body of water down here. Oh my God, we have run into a wild beast here on our bridge.
So this is the view from the top of the waterfall.
Over here I have Amy overlooking this waterfall. A lot of mist here today. This experience is very civilized, as this is the kind of walking way we have here in the jungle.
Right here we have a nice skip-long river, and it comes over here and it goes crashing down.
So let me remind the viewers that it is extremely hot and humid here. But this is just such a pleasant walk through the forest here. I don't know if you can tell from this video, but it's raining and I'm underneath that tree. So here we essentially have a family of these local critters. So here head off to the lower trail. You saw this on the deserted side earlier. So this is one of the better than average beaches right here.
Holy cow.
So this certainly is some of the more dramatic part of the falls. How about a picture here of some lovely flowers with, of course, another waterfall in the background. Regrettably, it's a little gray, but this hotel does have a very nice pool. So the chef's special tonight is a Argentine barbecue. So this is the view from our bedroom window.
So we're leaving Iguazu behind.
Although it may not be apparent, this means we're heading off to Buenos Aires. So here we are strolling along the waterfront here in Buenos Aires, hoping to find a beer, but things look very quiet. Here we are having our first meal in Buenos Aires down by the harbor. Here we are at our first time in Buenos Aires. So we have a menu here especially for gate one. And here we are at the port on a welcome dinner for the additional people. Here's my main course, and that is a serious piece of beef right there. So in the street below us, we have this guy who is a flamethrower.
representative to represent all the flowers in the world, so it's not a specific flower.
Into the very famous cemetery here in Buenos Aires.
This is a typical view here in the cemetery itself.
So here we have the mausoleum of Eva Perón Duarte. So here we have a gentleman playing the harp with the oldest church in Buenos Aires in the background. So this is alleged to be so here we are heading down on the side streets here in Boca. So here we have the wharf. And up here we have a picture of how it looked when it was painted. So here we are in the main square in Buenos Aires. Here we have a building that looks like a church. It's actually a museum. With the obelisk at the other end. Here we are in the oldest cathedral in Buenos Aires. We have a changing of the guard here. The floor has a wonderful mosaic. So here we are having a lovely meal, looking across a lovely park here in Buenos Aires. So here I am, I'm having two types of empanadas, and of course I have to have my bowl back with the water. So here we have the challenge of walking across probably the widest street in the world. So we're walking across Nove de Julio, and down there we have the obelisk. Walking our way to the bus to take a cruise. So down here we are loading up onto our boat for our cruise. So here we go down the old channel. So here we have a relatively spectacular looking structure. Well, we're leaving the main channel behind and heading off a bit smaller. It is a very famous house that has been protected by being enclosed in a glass structure. Over here we have a whole bunch of reeds.
100 years from now.
Up here we have a Ferris wheel. We are riding a steamer. conclusion of our little cruise here.
We were about to have lunch in this restaurant. And we were having an extremely slow lunch in this place.
So we're waiting to fly to Mendoza, and this is the most crowded airport I've ever seen.
After some of the delay, we are now off to Mendoza. So this is the view from our hotel room in Mendoza.
Viñanas Perdices, Reserva Malbec. 2021.
Wonderful. This is our first Malbec in Mendoza. Okay, so here we are having our first Malbec in Mendoza, Argentina. And here we are walking back to the hotel over here with a lovely Vermont. So here we are having a wine tasting at our hotel.
The first wine.
So here we are heading off for dinner. Here we are at the steak house in Mendoza. Here we have Pellegrino with Ratatouille. Of course, a glass of red wine. Here I have two scoops of dulce de leche. Very, very tasty.
This is a picture of the mountains from our hotel room. So here we are for our first wine tasting. So there's the vineyard with a snow-capped mountain in the background. So we're having this wine tasting on this lovely porch here.
Allowed to Quimera to change every year his composition, but not that.
Over there is the bus we're using today, and we're also going to use it to go to Chile tomorrow. So here we are at Norton. Isn't this a lovely view? No great surprise, but there are lots of tanks of wine here. So here we have a wall of Merlot from 93. So we are going to make our own blend from these different wines. So now we are making our blend.
Okay.
And now we have a label on our blended wine.
So we're at this lovely winery for a wine tasting and a lunch. We're being offered more wine here. So here is Amy next to a row of Sauvignon Blanc, which is her favorite grape. Here we are
sampling some rosé.
It's a Cabernet Franc Rosé.
So we're having empanadas and wine in this wonderful setting. And now lunch is over, and we're just sitting here with virtually unlimited wine. We're drinking wine underneath these trees.
You know, this part of Mendoza reminds me a little bit of Paris.
So here we are, about to leave Mendoza at 7 o'clock in the morning.
We have this kind of vegetation, this kind of bushes, one combination of different minerals. The red color comes from any current, and that part of the bowl, imagine, is very.
We have the highest mountain in the Western country. We are at the Argentinian border.
So exactly the limit, the border is in the middle of the tunnel. There is a little sign that indicates the limit Argentina, and then a little sign.
So here we are,
Is that Gasol?